You don't pursue. You know, we said the other day that it's part of the point I'm going to mention, but I'm not going to emphasize it. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and every other thing will be added unto you. You don't seek ye first every other thing, and then righteousness will be added. You pursue righteousness. We've discussed this before. So, love not the world, neither the things in the world. What does it mean not to love the world? I mean, what does it mean not to love the world? It means the practices of the world that are contrary to scriptures, that you and I know they are wrong. We shouldn't do them. We should only do the right things. We should only pursue the right things. We should only pursue the right purposes. That's what it means. Neither the things that are in the world, the practices of the world. Don't get yourself involved in them. If you want to be a transformed person, you want to live a transformed life, a changed life, a changed life. There must be a change. My hunger, my desire is to see every believer being changed. Every believer to be a changed person, changed individuals. We should not deceive ourselves. Let's not join them. If you can't bring them, join them. Don't join them. If you join them, you are heading to doom. That will not be a portion in Jesus' name. Step number three. For you to live a transformed life, there must be the willingness to have a renewed mind. Or I'll say renewed mindset. See Romans chapter 12, verse 2b says, when verse 2a says, and be not conformed to this world, 2b says, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Your mindset must change. The way you used to think, you should not think that way again. You used to think evil. You used to think how to steal, how to forge documents, how to lie, how to deceive people. All those mindsets must change for you to say you are living a transformed life. They must change. There must be a change in that mindset. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Now the word renewing of your mind suggests to us that renewing of your mind suggests to us that we must be renewing our mind daily. You understand what I'm trying to say? Because as you're even listening to me now, your mind would have flashed back to something. So you come to church, your eyes would have seen a sister in the wrong direction. As you come to church, your eyes would have seen a brother in the wrong direction. That's what I'm saying. So you need to be renewing that mind daily. Every second renewing the mind. When your mind is carrying you away, you say, no, I can't do that. You understand? Renewing of your mind. So it's I would say second by second thing. There must be a change every second. Because you may be so good in the presence of God. You may love the presence so nice. Oh, it's so cool. It's so wonderful. And when you get out there, your mind may focus something else. You need to renew it. Renewing of your mind. There must be renewal of your mindset. But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Every second your mind must change. Because your mind may lead you astray. Don't allow it to lead you astray. Sometimes I wonder the time is running so fast. Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians 4. I'm reading verses 22 to 24. That ye put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful laws, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. So put off your former conversation. Put on the old, put off the old man. Put on that thing that is making you that thing, that sin, as people put it, the sin that easily besets you, that is drawing you back. That thing that is moving you back. That thing that is making you not to give your all to the Lord. That thing that is making you to look at yourself and say, look, I have not really surrendered all to God. I have not really left the world. I want to do it, but something is drawing me back. I want to do it, something is drawing back. Hey, you need to pull those things that are drawing you back away. You need to pull them away. Your mindset will help you to do what? To pull them away. That's why I discovered my family. That is the mindset. When somebody says, I'm tired. Because you'll be walking, walking, walking. You are not tired. But suddenly, you now go to your comfort zone. And you now decide that you are tired. It's the mindset. The mindset has changed. But when you're not walking again, it's time to what? Rest. You say, I'm so tired. The mindset, I always said, I'm this morning. So the mindset. So the Bible is saying that mindset there must be and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that you may put on the new man. And the new man is the Spirit of God leading you. Leading you. Finally, point number four. Step to transform life. Willingness to accept and do God's will. Willingness to accept and do God's will. Willingness to accept and do what? And do God's will. Willingness to accept and do God's will. You know, that same book of Romans chapter 12. Let's turn back there. That's where we're getting our instruction from. Romans chapter 12. I'm reading verses 2, the third part of verse. It says that ye, okay, let me read from verse 2 again in the beginning. And be not to conform to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove that which is that prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. There must be willingness to accept and do the will of God. In other words, there must be the willingness in you to surrender your will unto the will of God. And what does it mean to surrender your will unto the will of God? Though we are not robots, we are not a computer that will be controlled by man, but when you give your life to Jesus Christ, you surrender your heart, because the devil walks through your heart, your mind and your heart. When you surrender those two, your mind, your heart, unto Jesus, and say, Lord Jesus, I surrender unto you. The Spirit of God comes into you to control your mind and your heart. Now, when you allow the Spirit to control your mind and your heart, then you have the willingness to do what? To accept and do God's will. Because the Spirit Himself will be telling you to walk in line with the will of God. The Spirit will not tell you to do anything contrary to the will of God. We're going to discuss something about the believer and the Holy Spirit. Or maybe next week. The believer and the Holy Spirit. Let's go on. Jesus Christ said in the book of Matthew, chapter 26, if you look at verse 39 and 42, when he was to face the death on the cross, he said, Father, if it is not possible for this cup to pass away from me, let your will be done. You must be willing to accept and do the will of God. When you are willing to do and accept God's will, you are living a transformed life. Because initially, you don't consult God. You take a decision yourself. I get my friend to say, you want your own will to what? To be done. But if you say you're living a transformed life, it's the will of God that must be done. Amen. Evidence of a transformed life. I'm going to rush through this because I've discussed this before. Evidence of a transformed life. That we want to look at. Number one, desire to pray ceaselessly. That means pray always. We've discussed that. I'm not going to into details in previous messages. Desire to study God's word always. Thirst after God's righteousness. See others, this is a point that we have not discussed. See others through the eyes of Jesus. You don't dictate through your own eyes. You see others. How will Jesus handle a situation like this? If you look at the Bible very well, time will not permit us. Matthew chapter 15, verse 32. Matthew chapter 9, 35 to 38. Matthew chapter 12, verse 15. Matthew 14, 14. If you look at all these ones, you'll see that the Bible says Jesus Christ had compassion.